Page 16, things y'all are probably, you know, very familiar with. Just be careful about illegal conditions. And you may say, well, that's great, Ken. What exactly is an illegal condition? It's anything you can't do. So I'm just kidding. That was glib too. An illegal condition might be, for instance, any sort of a quid pro quo sort of condition. If you do, if we grant this, you give the county that. That's a concern. Any sort of an exaction. We can't really do exactions. We can't enforce, force people to give up, money or resources by way of our zoning. Now that becomes a little different in the context of what I would call like project improvements. If in fact we adopt a zoning or give a zoning and we can impose conditions that are necessary, the standard is to ameliorate the impact of the zoning. So in other words, we say, we'll grant this zoning, but we would like maybe perhaps this intersection that's immediately outside of the subdivision expanded. Well, that is to directly mitigate or ameliorate the impact of that 400-unit subdivision that we just put in there. I believe that's legal. That's legal because otherwise, if we couldn't put that condition in there, you may be inclined to not recommend the zoning anymore because now the intersection's overloaded and you can't do anything about it.
What about donating the right-of-way?
That's in our UDC, and that's exactly what that's intended to do, is to mitigate the impact of that zoning.
And what if a developer on their own has agreed to donate for park purposes or whatever? That's okay if they...
If the developer is willing to do that and
condition themselves to that.
And that happens.
We've done that.
And that happens
many times.
A lot.
Yeah.
And that happens a lot.
Or a fire station or whatever.
They're trying to make the public feel better, and they actually sometimes come up with it on their own.
Well, a lot of times the developer can go farther than we're able to legally go. But they say, look, I know this may not be a perfectly tasteful zoning to a lot of these neighbors, but I'm willing to put up 40 acres of green space, or I'm willing to dedicate property for a library next to my development. Now, all of a sudden, the neighbors who were against it are like, well, now, wait a second.
Just as long as we're not
making them do it.
And a lot of times, and I don't know what y'all have been doing lately, and a lot of times, particularly if they are developer-proposed conditions that you've actually gotten them, that's fine. Sometimes in the heat of the negotiation, something may pop out where all of a sudden, for the first time, this is on the table, this condition. I like it if maybe on the record you could say, Mr. Developer, could you walk up to the podium? Now, this is a condition that's just been brought to our attention that apparently is the result of you negotiating with the neighbors back in the back. Are you agreeable to this? Mm-hmm. Yes, I am. All right. Well, now I'm feeling real good about that condition.
Now, what about if they have one very large parcel? They're splitting it and asking for zoning on one part, and then... we ask to improve the look of the entrance or something like that, which is on the part that remains and is not changed.
That's harder. I mean, if we're asking for any sort of improvements on a property that is not before the county, and when I say county, I mean the Planning Commission, the Board of Commissioner, that's harder. I mean, that's
even
harder.
Even though it started out as one parcel.
Yeah, I mean, if somehow during the process that parcel got lopped off, I like to keep my zoning conditions as close to the piece of property that's in front of you as is possible. Now, if they agree to it, I'm fine with that. And I wish I could tell you there's a bright line rule. Here's my rule. The farther away I get from the actual piece of property, the less likely a condition is to be enforced. So whereas I may be able to get the developer to even pay for because this goes to your question, remember that intersection improvement I was talking about? That intersection improvement is probably not on their property. It's probably on county property. But it's right out front of the development, and therefore I think I've got pretty good legal grounds to ask for that, because otherwise that intersection is a disaster. And if you think about it, of all the citizens in the county, who should be the one responsible for upgrading an intersection that their behavior is about to significantly impact? They are. That they should likely have to do that. So the farther away you get, though, whereas I could probably make them upgrade that intersection two lights down, a half mile away from their development, boy, I sure would like to upgrade that intersection as well. I'm not going to have any success there. So on your situation where it's the parcel that was part of it, just enhancing the beauty or attractiveness of the entrance, that's a lot closer call to me. I'd have to look at it. Yeah, it's a closer call to me. I mean, it depends. I mean, if you could make a direct link between the zoning you're about to approve and maybe that entrance, I could maybe see it. But if it's just, I'm not suggesting this of you, but if it's a, hey, this would be nice sort of thought, you're not gonna be able to do that.
But if they agree to it,
if they agree to
fine.
It, that's fine.
And they'll put it in writing.
Or you know,
as long as you don't make them agree to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's, and well, we got to think about that too. I mean,
they've got to bring it up.
I've had a developer, not so much lately, but in the
well, no,
in the old days, 2006, 2005, say, I didn't want to do it, but I knew that if I didn't do it, my zoning wouldn't get approved.
Well,
and you can request it. You can ask them. Yes, and if they comply, it's fine.
So you can't ask them, say, well, we want you to beautify, we want you to...
Yeah, they have every right to say no. They have every right to say no, and then if the answer is, well, we're going to deny your zoning, then that's something you'll need to talk to me about, if that's the position.
Well, and a lot of times, we're the liaison between the adjacent property owners or the public and a developer, and a lot of times the adjacent property owner has come to us with that particular request. So we can ask for that, but that doesn't mean that they would have to agree to do it.
Correct. Okay. That's right.
So the bottom line of what you're saying here is that one of our primary jobs here is to protect the county. By, you know, so as far as we don't do something that's going to cost the county a lot of money and legal fees, or we need to be kind of aware of.
Well, you're creating a record. That's mm-hmm. that's what you're doing. And so the protection of the county is creating the best zoning record we can have created. That's right. Mm-hmm. That's exactly yeah. right. And also
to cut down on the amount of work that you have to do. Because if you're having to work, then something is not right, and it's costing the county money. So we need to try to get it right the first time.
That's right. Okay. I mean, yeah, that's right. I mean, you know, the Planning Commission is a very, very important, influential board in this county, and you all have a lot on your plate. I mean, zoning and land use is key. I mean, it's key. Mm-hmm. And, you know, civil service board, you know, they handle the personnel matters, but they are not as often as your zoning matters. The ethics board handles what they handle. The dangerous dog board handles what it handles. But as far as regular, the number of matters you all handle, the frequency of your meetings, and the potential liabilities associated, y'all are it.
That's what I thought.
And so it's terribly important that you get these rules as correct as we can, that we establish a good record, and that we...
So we're doing an important thing here. You know, just because, I mean, the fact that the Board of Commissioners can completely ignore what we suggest or whatever we do here is important anyway.
It is important, and I will tell you, they don't ignore ever. They may not follow it.
Yeah,
but they don't ever.
They may not follow it, but still, you can't come back and say, well, the Planning Commission, we're not an important commission. We don't, you know, because all we do is just recommend.
No. I mean, yeah, it's only recommend, but it's sort of like the advice and consent of the Senate. I mean, it's that's important too.
Right. Yeah.